What's up YouTube? Nisa na. Hindi ka namin. What's the story? So what's up YouTube? So we have scenario here. The new drive shaft. Broken. As you can see. Fuck. So now we're gonna change the drive shaft. So the plan here is to trim the gearbox wheel first. And of course, one thing we know, we don't trim the gearbox wheel if we don't see the wheel pillar. Gearbox pillar like this one here. This is the pillar plan. So I'm gonna trim the gearbox wheel now. And then another plan. Remove the stabilizer link. The tap only. And let us bring the nut. And the last thing is this one here. The hub that holds the shock absorber. That's it. Okay. So that thing. Position.
Yeah. Luke gave me a push off the road.
What?
Luke, he gave me a push.
Really?
Yes, bro, that's what happened. He told me, he said, fix that thing already. He said it only take 10 minutes. He's all brand new, see, look.
Brand new, I see that,
yeah. One side, one side.
Brand new, yeah.
But the woman crashed it, so I reckon that bent or something.
Yeah, 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 that's why.
Leave that out.
Yeah. Leave me alone, yeah.
Just give me a fix, I won't.
Yeah, yeah.
So, we'll do this thing now. First things first, we're gonna need this eye protection. Because once your eye is stuck, then there will be no eyes on the market. It's for sale. So you have to gonna like, careful with your eyes. Especially when you're working with metal. Okay. So we're gonna look here. Normally encounter this grappling nut. So this comes out like very hard to get. Okay. The next thing to do is of course to remove this wiring harness. Just disengage the safety lock here. This is for the ABS. So we don't mess up with ABS. We're gonna disengage it very carefully. Okay, and the next is to remove the spindle nut. Spindle nut is like a 10 up 32 socket on it, yeah. And what we're gonna do to counter the rotation on the spindle nut in our tooling, is we're gonna put some brackets for the angle. Driver on the rotor ventilation on the top here, the back, like here. This will prevent from turning when you're removing the spindle nut. Okay, and then break it loose or crack open. Turn hard. Okay, once you crack it open, you're gonna, and that's it. And it's done. Next thing to do is this one. That's all the suspension. This is like a number 16 mil, and then 18 on the other side. Different sizes here. So 16 and 18 on the other side. Okay. So what we're gonna do here. This is 16. First thing, so we're gonna crack open here. To remove the retainer pin, the hose, the hose. I'm not sure what the retainer pin looks like. This one here, not a big hose. So you have the enough room to swing the suspension. Okay. Do it now. Use this basket to counter the rotation and then boot. Okay, that's it. Masih kenal. Oke. Sip. So, before to proceed, like I said, we're gonna drink the bus oil. Because we're really on that side now, so I'm gonna drink the bus oil. Make sure it is done clean, because we'll put it back after. So, this kind of position here. So the gearbox wheel, drain plug. You need this special key on all parts and sizes of the gearbox wheel plug. You have here, so you need a special key. Like, this is like a square head, drain bolt. So this is the perfect one, this is the perfect size. And this is milk. So we're gonna open up the gearbox wheel now. In the gearbox, we're gonna bring the gear box set. Beforehand, we're gonna clean it first. And then, once you clean it, then make sure, yeah, and then just turn it down. And once you're closest here, bring your pan, oil pan. This is a DIY oil. So the gearbox will still clean, still good. Then we'll clean that one. Basically, when you remove the oil drain plug, you should change also the freaking washer, the first one. Okay. So there's a piece after the oil. So like anything you do, especially doing the oil drain plug, whatever, oil use, always change phrase, washer for the drain plug. Oil drain plug washer. We have here, so this is we have here, this is the first one, this is the new one, and this is the old one here. The reason why, because this is already pins, like being fresh already, and this one is not, it's round, so we're gonna put the drain plug. Okay, always use my hand first, 3 to 4 turns, let's see this one, the thread, you see, this time. Just tighten it, just feel the, if the oil drain plug stops turning, then that's it. Don't tighten it, don't over tighten it, because you will feel the lip shift. Over tighten that thing. These are cast iron, so it's very delicate, right? So you need to be careful removing those things. And since we're ready to go, we're gonna remove the drive shaft now. That's the whole process here. So the good thing is, it's very easy for us here. Okay, this is perfect. So just quick jump. See, it's broken, completely broken. And then we're gonna fry it out from the inside. Inside. Back here, inside. Yeah. See? Okay. And then once you've done that, just pull it out. So that's the tool. Pull it out. And make sure when you put back in, make sure the new one has the ring on the spline. Because this is the lock. When you push it in, this ring will expand, like split up. That will lock in the drive shaft for the gears inside. Here is the new one here. This is the new one. I'm gonna clean it up a little bit. And then we put some oil on this shaft here to keep a lubricant. Just keep it. The purpose of that lubrication on the oil seal. Keep the oil seal lubricated and it slides easily. So hold it tight as we're gonna push it inside. Only inside. Like I said, just double check. This ring here has to be on the head on. This will lock up here inside. So just slowly and then stone until it will ride on the spine inside. Once it's on, push, and that's it. And then here, just push in here. And so, and it's on. And then business. So, I can run my hands. That's it. And then the double check fork. Okay, snag. And then put that in the spindle nut here. Gonna torque it down. 120 newton meter, sit up. And then I'm gonna pump in the gearbox oil. So we are removing now the brake hose. We will put that later on after position this and remove the filler plug first. Okay. Okay. So guys, as you know, this is not the you can also repel gearbox oil from here, but I seem to be like when I open this one, it's some kind of small opening in here. Like there's like this is like a kind of a reverse sensor here, like yeah. So it has a ball bearing when I took it off. Like this is some kind of the reverse on the system here. It has a ball bearing inside that will determine the engaging of the gear. But the drain filler plug is a tool here. That side here. See that there? That has a plastic thing. So never, that's the filler plug. And put it. We're gonna do now. So like I said, you can also repeal it from here. But this is a very small opening here, so it's not the thing to do. The filler plug on the gearbox will also on the front with the plastic thingy. Okay, so we're gonna pump it now. We're gonna pumping around here using a manual tool. This is a tool here. We're gonna pumping around this oil. Bring this oil in. So it's sticking. It's pumping out. It's pumping oil now. So that will be in. Oil in no time. So that's my stupid mistake there. I was not looking for the thing. So yeah. Anyway, you can still use that freaking thing in there to pump in the gearbox oil, but it will take time. And like this white open here on the frapper oil filler plug, where we can pump in the gearbox oil. And it looks like it's very, very convenient for us to pump in. So the gearbox oil on this thing is like kind of 2 liters. It makes 75-90, very common for the gearbox oil. You can use also the 10W40 to like as a gearbox oil, 10W40, but I may not recommend the 10W40 because the viscosity on that one is very thin, like, know what I mean? And then 10W40 is like it's not similar of what the oil compound or elements that on it, because the gearbox oil is truly specialized for the gears, obviously for the gears. That's why it's called gearbox oil. The 10W40 is the engine oil, and that's the big difference there. But if you have no gearbox oil available on your area, then you can use 10W40 as gearbox oil, but not necessary. Only if it is not available, you can use the 10W40 as gearbox oil. Only if not available, and you need to use the car immediately. So you may use for temporary, but not for long time. So it's done now. We're pumping 2 liters of oil in the gearbox oil, and it's done. We're gonna close the drain plug. That's not the thing, huh? So here, we have here, you can see the plastic thing there. Just clean up. And clean, push the mount in here. Turn it on. Okay. And this is only tied by hand. Tied by hand. And then just type it snug with your vice grip, whatever you use. Snug tight. That's what to do is to put this thing back in the gap link, etc. And then the tire, the top tire, this thing will go. So that's how you do your gas oil thing, guys. You can do it on your own, but if you don't have the thing, you can message me on my Facebook page, message me on the channel, write down below comment, whatever, and then I'm gonna get back to you whenever I am ready. But sometimes I cannot comment immediately because like I said, too busy, no? I'm too busy doing things. So, like, need to understand. Okay, I'm gonna kind of hammer it down. And then put back in the controls on the freaking EBS wire harness. And then, this wheel here. Put a little bit on the freaking stabilizer nut. And then, we'll hold tight. That's it, guys. We're done. Both the time back in and we got ready to with this drag. Okay. See these things here? This is the best brand ever. Best drag. Not only the best drag, they are the makers of the car parts. Best drag. Like almost of the parts is best drag can do. Like the timing belt. Best drive parts, injectors, best drive. They're actually the makers of the parts too. No, the best drive is from Continental, I said. Yeah, Continental. So best drive and Continental, they are like these things here. But this is the best option for the tire also. I'm not pushing, but I'm not pushing to buy products like this, but this is the best tire. That's why it's called best drive. Thank you. Good job. Thanks. That's it. Thank you.